What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 37 of the Ultimate Let's Play Dragon Quest IX. We are at Swinedimples Academy at night. And no, my emulator is not muted. There is no music going on right now. Now, I had to do a couple of dry runs of this area. And I've actually put Blue and Terra back to their former classes because I figure I'm going to need some healing and I'm going to need a little extra firepower. I've kept Maxim as a gladiator because I hope to use his coup de grace move, which will basically jack up his tension as high as it can go in the boss fight that's to come. But first, we're going to take care of business here. We're going to meet a friend, the guys here. Need to touch the statue to move on. And it looks like we're going to get a cutscene here. Fred, you may want to look behind you here. You may want to reconsider that, Fred. Geez, he just possessed Fred. Okay, Fred, don't do anything rash like that. So now we're gonna have to go and rescue Fred. He's been possessed, now we gotta find him. Oh yeah, I did also want to mention that off-camera I went ahead and cashed my mini-mills. Unfortunately, did not get anything at this time. But as you see right here, there's Fred. He's at the grave. And we got a hidden doorway. Okay, looks like this is going to be our next dungeon. We have reached the old school. Got a lot of new enemies here, so... Now I'm going to try and collect the treasures first. I only have to fight them as I have to. I'm going to start with the Raving Reaper. We've also got a Terra some new drill arms. Uh-oh, Zammel. Ouch, that is some damage. Yeah, that's an attack we're really gonna have to keep our eye on here. But yeah, anyway, as I was mentioning, I got Terra new claws. They're basically drill-shaped claws. I think that's the most powerful I can get him, man. I just got Blue an old staff. Not that he's gonna be using it for offense or anything like that. Oh, we got a mini mill out of the blue chest. Really, that could have been anything. Trying to see where we need to go next. How do I get to that chest over there? I think we're going to have to go this way and take this guy on. Well, it's a new enemy. And we got two new enemies, Tiki Mask and White Priest. But boy, I hate fighting groups of enemies, especially when I'm at this late in the game. And this is one of the reasons why I had Blue go back to being a priest. And the Tiki Mask can block attacks. They'll basically defend their allies. Wonder why they're gunning for Blue now. Whatever we did, it didn't affect Blue at all. Here comes Parallax from Maxim. And paralyzed him. Cool. Now we can focus on the White Knights. I mean White Priests. White Knight was episodes ago. Unfortunately, Wack's not working against these guys. Here comes Swoosh. Hits all guys. Luckily, not too damaging. Tiki Man still can't move. There's my Falcon Slash dealing a knockout. Oh no, these guys know Zing. He just revived the first Tiki Mask. Even worse, I hate enemies that know Zing. Zing, as you know, is the revival spell of this game. There's also a more powerful version called Kazing, which is basically like a max revive. Basically completely revitalizes a dead ally. Luckily, Zing only partially heals. Got a lot of experience out of that. And unfortunately, I don't think we get credited twice for killing that one enemy. I'm gonna go ahead and heal up because we'll probably get to fight this guy. I don't think I can get around him. Wait a minute. He just walked right past me as I was healing. Talk about a lucky break. Let's grab this treasure chest. We got a Seed of Therapeutics. I think this is one we haven't seen yet. Let's see what it increases. Magical Mending. So let's give it to Blue. Alright. Got a Tiki Mask up there. White Priest there. Go ahead and take this guy on. Luckily, this guy's flying solo, so I don't have to worry about Zing. And don't have to worry about multiple attacks either. Looks like we're going to have to go through the door to get to that last treasure chest. Go through the poison puddle. Don't want to stay in there too long. I don't think these bookcases have anything. Going in here, we got a brainy bracer. Let's see if it'll benefit anybody here. It'll increase magical mind mending, but really knock down our defense. I don't think the trade-off's worth it. Just trying to split the uprights there. We just couldn't avoid that one guy. Luckily, it was just one guy I had to deal with. Back over the poison puddle. We can go ahead and work our way to the north. Have to deal with another of these white priests. Let's see if Whack will work. I'm not going to give up on that move. It's helped me quite a bit in the past. Unfortunately, Crackle's not doing too much. And Whack didn't work. And it just used Zing. So I gotta kill that guy all over again. Glad to have Terra using her claws again. It's the nice thing about this game. If you can change vocations, you can always change back and pick up right, literally, right where you left off. So I didn't lose any levels. I basically kept all my abilities, all my stat changes. Speaking of stat changes, maximum level 17. Attack on Thornmorch was Axe Skill. He's now 5 away from learning the Helm Splitter. Blue got to level 25 in the Priest Field. Nothing new for him, though. Alright, through the door. I don't think there's anything to that other passageway, so we're just gonna head downstairs. Burn some superior medicines here, trying to salvage my MP. Here down the second floor. I do... Yeah, there are some alchemy recipes here. I think there's more in the other corner. Nothing there. Got some gold. Got some more gold. Unfortunately, I could not avoid the Reaper. Though I shouldn't fear the Reaper. It should fear me. As if I can get a good jump on him here. Well, I think Blue's still batting zero with that whack attack. Fortunately, Parallax didn't paralyze. Yeah, Blue just stick with healing there. I was afraid he was going to use Zing there. Again, I have to have Zing myself. I've never had to use it up to this point yet. Terra's ready for a coup de grace. I should stick with the physical attacks. I don't think Crackle's going to do anything. Let's see if Terra can stun him. Roaring tirade. Froze all three enemies. Jacks retention a bit. And Max was very close to dying there. That's why I had him defend instead of attack there. Honestly, it wasn't worth the risk. I'm death free up to this point, and I hope to keep it that way for as long as I possibly can. I wonder if I may be able to actually go the distance and beat the whole game without a single character dying. That'd be something that I don't think I've ever pulled off in any RPG at all. Well, whack didn't work, but I got a critical off that hit. Okay, finally. At least these guys give good experience, so in case I need to, do a little bit of grinding. This looks like a good area. Get some more recipes here. I also believe there's a treasure chest to the south. Got a Wayfarer's Clothes, and again, we could not avoid the Reaper there. Oh, we got another new enemy, the Sculptress. Not quite sure right off the top of my head what that guy's capable of. Basically, I just gotta get rid of the numbers game here. So that's gonna be my big problem. And I really hate that Zamel attack. That guy did some pretty good damage to Maxim there. Yeah, Blue, you gotta stay on top of the healing here. Not bad. Down two. Oh, jeez. Nothing worse than a haywire multi-target magic attack. That put Terra virtually near death here. I may have to have her defend. Now, second thought, the hell of it, let's go for it. Well, I took a chance there and it paid off. I didn't think I could get a mid-heal off before the enemy attacked. Blue's ready for coup de grace, but He's not going to be able to get a chance to use it. And here's that treasure chest I was talking about. We have an Einhander. Looks like a glove accessory. I'll have to take a look at it. Let's see if anyone could use the Einhander. Get a huge increase in deafness. I think I want to keep those ultramarine mittens, so I'll give that to Terra. Alright. Who got out of his way? Got out of his way. I'm actually surprised we avoided that one. Yeah, down here is where the boss is, so I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. In the next episode, we'll take on the boss and go after the final fig. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.